Hello guys, welcome back to another V4 mobile video. In this video guys, I'm gonna tell you how I got to level 60, actually level 60 plus, and also almost 50,000 CP or power as a free-to-play player. So guys, let's get started. So as you can see right now, my level is 60.41%, okay, and my CP or combat power or power is 48,569. I think I can get to 50. I'm gonna see how. And I'm at the, let's see, the story, how much of the story I managed to complete. So I'm on the last chapter, the Subterranean Secret, guys. Okay, so I started already that one. And the map, let's check the map. The last zone, this is the one, okay? So if I go here, Deku's Volcano, guys, from 65,700 to 100,000 combat power. But I have less, but I can still do at least the beginning area, okay? So this is the map. Here you can see some of the monsters. Okay, they look like birds, pterodactyls, or yeah. Okay, so guys, how I managed to do that as free to play, and also you can do the same. So let's get started. First, leveling up. When it comes to leveling up, guys, you have to stick to the main quest as much as you can. Don't forget to take these ones, the conquests, because every area you move, you get the conquest, and you're gonna see why. Conquest, you can see them also on the map. If you click the map, each of these zones, see, like let's select the 66, this one, or this one, or this one. See, in this one, I sent a worker, and you can do the same to do this conquest. And this one gives you imprint stone. These are very important, and also soul shards and some experience and gold. So doing that is very important. You're gonna see why. So when you level up, try to take the conquest quest, because they will appear once you reach a different zone, and do the main quest. Okay, so stick to the main quest. And I'm gonna show you also how you can increase your CP so you have no problem continuing to do the main quest, because the best way to level up, guys, is doing the main quest. I didn't find any right now any better way than doing the main quest, the story quest. So those will give you a lot of experience. So now let's see another thing that will increase your experience, guys. I told you in my previous guide video, beginner's guide, are this potion, advanced best blessing potion. This will increase your experience by 200% and also loot by 100%. You can activate the big one for 2 hours, smaller ones 30 minutes, and so on. So don't forget to activate those every time. Another important thing, guys, when it comes to leveling up and powering up, are the pets. Okay? Pets, as you can see, I got this one. This gives me experience, 90% more experience. Also, they give you different stats. The more you have, all those stats, actually, no, they won't add up. But if what you want to find are the ones that give you a lot of experience, okay, like this one, the higher the grade, the more experience and more stats you get, okay, like this one, 280% experience. That's crazy. Attack, accuracy, and other stats. So this is OP, but I think you, I don't know if you can get it right now from the cash shop, but this is an OP pet. So pets are very, very important. Okay, next. Oh, I forgot to show you my ranking, guys. My ranking, if you don't believe me, rank is level 128. Actually, it's higher. Let me see, top 100. Yeah, I'm about there. Okay, and CP 131. So highest CP is 80 something. No, 90 now. 90,000. Okay, so I'm up there, guys. I'm up there. And let's resume. So we said a very important role play the pets and the mounts, guys. So try to get mounts like this one. Attack speed in sorry, attack speed increase and weight increase and critical hit and other stats. The higher the grade, the more of these stats. Like check this one or this one. Up to 100% attack speed increase, that's crazy. Critical hit, critical damage, and all those stats. So these ones I'm gonna show you where you can get every day free, besides the missions, quests, and events. Every day, guys, you should go to shop, and in the shop you have, for example, mounts, okay? And you can buy see, I already bought two per day of each type. So the shiny mounts, two of them for 50k gold. Then you can get impressive mounts, another two for 20k each, and radiant mount. So you have a chance to get the purple mount, 100,000 gold, okay? Also two per day. So all this buy every day, guys. That's how you can get lots of free mounts. Same with the pets. See, I already bought them. So you can use a game currency, the gold, and buy every day. That's how you can get lots of these pets and mounts. Plus, you get for free those, let me see if I still have them. See these ones? Daily pet egg supply and daily mount supply. So those you get also for free. Let's go back to shop, because in here, besides this one, I suggest to check also if you need the ring, but they are kind of expensive. You can buy also with 1 million, but those are expensive. Another important thing to check are the daily products, okay? You can buy also with gold, like enhancement materials, see, for weapon, armor, accessories. You can buy imprint stones. These are very important, guys. The imprint stones, you're gonna see why. And let's see what else. Weekly products, I don't know if, no, in here you don't have much, but the daily. So try to buy this stuff every day, guys. Okay, then you have other shops. You have currency shop, sorry, not currency shop, event shop. Global coins, guys. From here, you can get enhancement scrolls, imprint stones, which I told you are very important, enchantment totems. I'm gonna show you what you can do with those. Also, you can buy soul stones, are very important. So I bought all of this. This helped me a lot, increase my power. How you can get the global coins? There is an event. Also, guild events. You have these ones, mileage, and then I'm gonna show another shop. So how you can get the global coins, guys? Okay, global. See, from here, coin mission event. So you have to complete different stuff, like complete daily mission 60 times, or eliminate 8 region bosses, or complete region conquest 20 times, attempt upgrade a soul stones 5 times. So all this, okay? Now let's see. So best ways, guys, to increase your CP or power. Let's see, one of the ways is gear. The higher the grade, the better. Also, gear you can enchant, you can enhance, and I'm gonna show you. You can add those jewels, let's call them jewels, or soul stones. Okay, how I managed to get full purple gear, as you can see. Well, guys, I got it from my mama. No, sorry, I'm not. I got it. So I got it from doing story. Okay, so from story you get all the gear you need, guys. Plus other stuff, you can get this blue gear, which is also decent. And then from completing chapter 5, you get full epic gear. the purple gear, okay? And then what I did, I enhanced it to plus 5, because that's the maximum you can enhance this purple. Maybe because it's from the quest. So also, is plus 5 is a safe enhancement for the gear. For accessories is plus 2. If you go higher and you need this enhancement materials, you can break the gear or accessories, so I don't recommend, okay guys? So enhancer gear, that's another way to upgrade it, okay? And you need this enhancement materials I showed you can get from shops, you can get from quests, from events and so on, and other game content. So it's not that hard to get them, you get lots of them actually. Then another way to improve your gear is magic enchantment, guys, okay? So what is this? You need these books, like this one, and you can see right there the stats that you can get. For this one, max stage is 5, where I get 280 attacks, and the minimum stage is attack stage 1 with attack 30. You want to get stage 5, attack 230. Me, I got stage 3, attack 100. Let me try again. So there is a chance that I'll go higher or lower, or it will fail. So this time it failed, see? So I have the previous. If it fails and you already have an enchantment, you'll keep the previous enchantment, okay? Let's try again. Come on! Okay, so again, didn't work. So anyways, I already enchant, so I suggest to enchant, maximum is 5. 5 I got for, I think, one or two of those gears. Then you have gear abilities, but I didn't manage to unlock this. Those abilities you can extract from some, see, ability stone extraction. So you extract from some type of stone or gear, I'm not sure. I didn't unlock this yet. Okay, next guys, another very good way, soul stones to improve your CP are the soul stones, guys. These ones you can equip your gear. Like blue gear, you can equip one. In epic gear or purple, you can equip two. And legendary, three. Legendary, I think, is the yellow gear. And these ones also can be leveled up, okay? And also, you can upgrade them. You can level up these ones using, let me see if I have in here. I'm gonna show you. So you use these soul shards, guys, to upgrade them, okay? So these ones, and these are the, if I want to upgrade this one, for example, I use this soul shards. Let's select OK and see, to level up to 10, then you can upgrade. Next guys, another way to increase your CP fast is, guys, potential. Okay, potential, you have three different ones and you can level them up using this, let's call using gear that you don't need, and add gear, accessory, doesn't matter, and these materials, okay? And you level up, boom, all three of them. So first you get the first one, then every level you get, not every level, a specific level you get new ones. In total there are three. Next, super important guys, super important way to increase your CP is imprinting, guys. See, I max this one, demon stones. See how many? 1, 2, 3, we got how many? Maximum 5. I'm at the fourth one. And this one, I have all to level 17. What you need for this one, imprint stone. And I told you how you can get these imprint stones, and you can get lots and lots of them from doing the quests. And especially, guys, if you check the map I showed you, from doing the Okay, let me see if I have. See this one. Region conquest. Okay, this gives me 180. You can send, you can do yourself, or you can send your workers, guys. So you can do that one time for each of these regions, like this one, this one. For each of these regions, and there are lots of them. You can go all the way behind, see, like here, I already did. So you can do with your workers and send them in this conquest, because you'll get lots and lots of those imprint stones. And that way, plus you can get imprint stones from the abyss, okay? So abyss, you can farm them in there also. Also, you can get more level from the abyss, by the way. Okay, now, let's see. Next thing about imprinting, you can add this demon stones, okay, that give you different stats. This gives me evasion 136. There are four in total for each of these demon stones. See, are those things on the edges? This gives me attack 48, and also these demon stones have different grades. For example, let me see, I think I have some. Yeah, this one is better. It has two stats, evade and sprite attack. Okay, they can come even in with higher grades and more stats, higher stats. So let me auto imprint. You can choose to auto imprint or do it manually. So these imprint stones, if you get lots of them, you can increase your power a lot. So, as an idea, 1,000 of these imprint stones can give you more than 1,000 CP. More than 1,000 CP. So try, and you can farm more than 1,000 per day imprint stones. Way more. Okay, now, let's see what else. Another way, skills, level up your skills. Okay, that can help. Another thing. Talents, yes, talents, guys. You unlock this later on if you didn't, and you can increase critical hit, then mana points is different for every class, then skill attack, and then it will branch out. You have different branches, so you have to choose which branch you want. So that's another way to increase your CP and also customize your character to your own liking. Okay, another way to add CP power, guys, is research. If you hit research, you get for each monster, and I suggest especially the beginning areas, to get to the highest level you can. Yeah, I got this one to 4, because they will give you extra CP, extra stats. So how you can get these ones? From hunting those monsters, they will drop, it's like gaining knowledge, okay? They will drop those markings, and you can level up. For each region, you have those, all those monsters to level up and get all kinds of stats. So research is very important also. Then you have item sets. So if you register, okay, specific items, you get all these stats. See, accuracy, evade, and so on. So you check and you see if you can register, you have those gears, and then you can get gain extra stats. These stats will be on all your characters, okay, those stats. Okay, so I think these are the most. Also, feats can increase CP applied 510. So this, you do different tasks every day. From adventure, growth, life, and so on. So this one also can increase your total CP. And companions, they give you different stats. And companions, guys, they have different grades, higher grades, they have higher stats. And also, it's very important, send them to do different tasks. Gathering, some are for conquest, and conquest can give you lots of those imprint stones, like I showed you. So guys, do all those things that I told you, and you should be it should be easy for you to reach also to level up fast and increase your CP fast. So I did this in 3 days as free to play. And another thing before I close, there are different types of coins. And I'm gonna show you like this one, see? And there is this Penguin Exchange House. In here, guys, you can gain, you have a chance to gain radiant pets and mounts, as you can see with these coins. Also, you can get in enhanced scrolls, imprint stones, and enchantment totems. So check all these all these shops in here with different coins. These coins you get from doing all those events, doing all those missions. Okay, you'll get those coins. So there are many ways you can check the coins, and they to specify right there from where you can get each type of coin. So this was, guys, my tips for you. Let me know how high you managed to reach with the level and CP, and see you in the next video. Bye, guys.